Bwana kija juu yako.
Let the favor of God come on you today.
I receive the favor of God.
Let the favor of God come on you today.
Napokea kibali cha Bwana.
If you know what God is doing right now,
kama unajua kile Bwana anatenda sasa hivi,
you have a reason to celebrate Jesus.
Ungekuwa ukisimama ukipiga makofi.
We celebrate. Yeah.
Stop for a minute.
Keti tuonge, keti chini.
So, guys, oh,
skizeni, watu.
The famine did not come to one person or your family.
Kiangazi haikuja kwa mtu moja ama familia ndogo.
But it came like nation.
Ilikuja kwa taifa.
Joseph.
Yusufu.
Still in the midst of famine,
katikati ya ile ukame,
his father sent him.
Baba yake akamtuma,
go help your enemy.
Nenda usaidie maadui zako.
Your biggest enemies,
adui yako mkubwa,
are not the enemy you call.
Sio wale ambao unawajua.
Your biggest enemies,
adui zako wakubwa,
are the people you call friends.
Ni wale unaita marafiki.
Friends will never push you to your prophetic destiny.
Marafiki ambao hawakusukumi katika hatima yako.
Your enemies will do.
Maadui wako watakusukuma.
That's why Jesus stood and he said, bless your enemies.
So kasema bariki maadui zako.
Because you cannot do well without enemies in this earth.
Maana hii dunia hautaendelea bila maadui.
You can only do and get into the place as fast where God wants you to get.
Utafika mahali ambapo Mungu anataka.
When you get so much enemies.
Wakati unapata maadui wengi.
He set a table before my enemies, not my friends, not my brothers.
Ameniandalia meza mbele yangu.
The Lord revealed to me. He said to me, do you know when David wrote that Psalm 23?
Wakati Daudi aliandika ile Zaburi.
He wrote it when Samuel came to anoint him.
Aliandika wakati Samueli alikuja kumwagia mafuta.
When Samuel came,
wakati Samueli alikuja.
Samuel said, we will not sit down. We will not sit down until David comes. So that means there was a table and they will sit.
Hi.
So I will not sit down. So that's been that guy, the father,
Isaac,
he was old, but he was supposed to stand until David has to come. May your helpers never sit down until they come. Those who
are
supposed to bring you your contracts, your millions, your business, may they come. May they have no rest until they fulfill that which is yours. Come on, someone receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it.
I take it. Hey. Hey.
They could not sit down until David has to come from the forest. It took one day for him to arrive.
Ah,
may they transport you like a boss. So that means someone with the oil waiting for David. David to come. He has bypassed Saul. He has bypassed his brothers. Just to announce amen in the forest. Why? Because his brothers, his fathers, his mother, they could not celebrate him when he killed the lion, when he killed the bears, just to keep the fathership.
God
send people who shall testify on your behalf. And when he was brought there, people
of God,
the table was set and his enemy was seated and he
said,
he anoints my cup, my head,
sema ni mwagie mafuta,
and my cup overflows.
Kikombe changu kinafurika.
So that means his enemies were looking.
Wake walikuwa
wanataka. It is David getting anointed.
Daudi anamwagiwa mafuta.
It is David receiving the grace.
Daudi anapokea neema.
It is David getting blessed.
Daudi anabarikiwa.
Ah. My God, my God, my God, my God. All your enemies in your business area.
Maadui wako katika biashara.
Anyone jealousing your prosperity.
Yote ambaye anakuonea wivu.
Anyone jealousing the moment you're about to sign a contract.
Anayekuonea wivu kwa sababu
ya kazi yako. Anyone jealousing the moment a man is supposed to transfer.
Anayekuonea wivu usipate pesa.
Anyone jealousing your marriage.
Yeyote anakuonea wivu kwa ndoa.
Let there be fire on them.
Wacha pawe na moto juu yao.
Shout fire.
Fire.
Shout fire.
Fire.
Ah, I can hear you.
Fire.
Ah.
Fire.
Ah, do it well.
Fire.
Woo. Listen,
Skiza
will watch you.
you are
prospering.
I receive it.
We are going to watch you having your own as well. We are going to watch you walking in that place in a white suit. We are going to watch you driving also the best. We are going to watch you finishing your school. We are going to watch you traveling in the nation you used to dream.
Ukiwa na kile ni chako.
Now the devil is a bad devil.
Shetani ni shetani mbaya mkorofi. Tena mjeuri.
He didn't even want you to travel abroad.
Akutaka uende tu hapa nyuma.
What is it abroad that people are coming out?
Pale watu wanatoka.
But he's stopping you to go abroad. Injustice, injustice.
Imefika mwisho. Hiyo ni kukosa haki.
Kwani what is it in Europe?
Kwani Europa
where people are dying,
mali watu wanakufa,
and they are looking for food,
na anatafuta chakula,
and he, the devil, is stopping you.
Na shetani anasema usisafiri,
to go to Europe.
Uende mkulima.
Just here.
Apa.
8 hours you reach.
Masaa manane. Ni kama kuenda Mombasa.
That's an injustice.
Hiyo ni kukosa haki. Shetani
mbaya. No, you can't refuse that situation.
Tumekataa kwa jina la Yesu.
Any embassy that has been refusing you.
Yeyote ambaye amekufungia milango.
By fire, by thunder.
Kwa moto, kwa radi.
I pray.
Naomba.
Let there be an open door.
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 I'm telling you, I'm seeing the lion face. The lion of Judah is in this house. I see the lion of Judah.
The lion of Judah.
He's standing right now on your situation.
The lion of Judah.
He's standing on your behalf.
The lion of Judah.
Receive breakthrough.
The lion of Judah.
Receive breakthrough.
The lion of Judah.
The Lord said to me, do this. Receive breakthrough.
I receive.
Receive breakthrough.
I receive.
Receive breakthrough.
I receive.
Iya la 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 dele makalaba. Switzerland, beat Germany, beat US, beat Canada,
Canada,
beat UK,
UK,
beat France,
France,
beat whatever,
Britain,
beat Dubai,
Dubai,
Qatar,
Qatar,
wherever.
Oman,
receive it.
I receive it.
Receive it.
I take it.
Receive it.
I take it.
Receive it.
I.
Hey, the devil is a liar.
Shetani ni mkorofi.
God gave you the earth, not a nation.
Mungu amekupatia dunia hii yote si
taifa. God gave you the earth, not a city.
Alikupatia
sio mji. He said enjoy the world.
Akasema furahia dunia yote.
How come he want to restrict you into a village?
Sasa akuweke kijijini kwenu kwa matope. Matope ni mbulbul. Shetani ashindwe. Geshagi shetani ashindwe. Ashindwe shetani. Hai.
Long time in the Bible, they used to enter cities and nations without paying any amount.
Lingia miji
bila kulipa. They just see the gate, they say we want to enter, they enter.
Tunaona mji tunaingia.
Today you have to pay visa.
Leo unalipa visa.
So which devil is that was not stopping people before?
Sasa huyo ni shetani mgani
anasema. Now he's stopping you to enter other places.
Sasa anafanya usiingie mahali kwingine usafiri na ndege.
That means there are some principality have increased.
Namaanisha kuna nguvu tena zimejijaja.
The devil has increased his manipulations.
Shetani ameongeza ujuzi wake.
Against the children of God.
Kinyume na watoto wa Mungu.
I like that. Katika jina la Yesu.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Shetani ashindwe.
Ashindwe milele tena ashindwe mfululizo. Shetani ashindwe mfululizo. Katika jina la Yesu.
Okay. Just up your, have your seat, have your seat, Father.
Katie.
No.
Tumekata.
Listen, the devil has played with many Christians. If you're listening to me.
Kristo wengi wale wananisikiza.
Listen, there are some things you should not pray for.
Kutoka leo baba, kuna vitu sitaombea tena.
Listen. Even the devil can see you are not supposed to pray. He's just manipulating you.
Hata shetani anaona hii usiombe.
Things like to pray and to bind the devil for visa.
Unaombea vitu? Vitu gani?
Because someone has not prayed, he has just gone with the passport and put there. He never prayed and entered.
Mtu ameenda na
passport. Why just for Africa you have to enter 3 days of fast and pray? Dry fast.
Lazima uingie dry fast.
Siku tatu bila maji.
I don't know, maybe you are quiet because maybe you are not familiar where we are coming from.
You are speaking to me.
People enter 14 days of prayer and fasting just to go to embassy to go where? Europe.
What
to eat, to eat baga.
Miaka 40 wakakule baga Europe.
To see the wind. To feel the cold.
Wasikie
baridi. To wear a nice jacket.
Wabaye,
and to put
hulala.
A picture that I'm in Europe.
Wabaye hulala.
People are dying through the season of fasting and prayer just
watu
to see Europe. And when they open their eyes, they are dead. They see heaven. Better even than Europe.
Ata afadhali hapa, kuna chakula.
So God answered their prayer because you could see
Mungu
this one is so ignorant. Let me just show you heaven.
Wacha nimuonyeshe binguni vile kunaka Europe kumeshindwa.
I used to be ignorant the same. I used to see Europe like everything. But I'm telling you, the time is coming where Europe will actually see Africa better.
Europe itaona Africa ndio kuna faa. That deserves a shout and a standing ovation for Africa.
There are more people who are broke. Seriously broke. Depending on the government. For their food, even to the place where they're supposed to sleep. You in Africa here,
Apa Africa,
you have even everything.
Una kila kitu.
You can fight, you get Katuan, you get here, and there is no taxes. Where, which tax are you paying?
Hakuna, unalipa gani? Unalipa kodi gani?
There is freedom in Africa.
Apa kuna uhuru Africa.
And you want to check it out.
Na
you want to check out and go somewhere.
Unataka kutoka ukasikie baridi.
Oh, God has you. God has you in mercy. Don't worry. God has you.
Jesus, help us.
It's good to be in Europe.
Ni sawa twende Europe.
But you will go and come back.
Lakini unaenda unarudi.
You are not going to take refuge there.
Unarudi.
You are not going to change your name.
Hamtabadilisha jina yako.
You are not going to change your passport unless favor comes your way.
Passport yako mpaka upate kibali.
Oh, am I prophesying to someone?
You're prophesying, Papa.
May God bless you until a level you see Europe is not everything.
I receive.
Remove the small mentality. Get the big blessing mind in you.
The
greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Can I say something and then I close? Now, on the way, blessing his enemies.
Baraka kibariki madui yake.
On his way.
Pale njiani Yusufu.
In the time of famine.
Wakati wa ukame.
Again.
Tena.
He faced a betrayal.
Akakutana na kusalitiwa.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Wake kwa waume.
When there is crisis coming in your life.
Wakati kuna shida maishani.
Oppositions.
Vita na upinzani. Huh? Yeah.
Opposition.
Upinzani.
Crisis.
Shida.
When it comes in your life.
Ikija kwako.
It's coming to promote you.
Inakuja kukupandisha cheo.
You see? God could not do his promises to Joseph until he can send until he can send a famine.
Mungu lazima angetuma ukame ili kwamba amuinue Yusuf.
So there was no miracle. Watch me. There was no miracle until a famine is sent.
Apakuwa na muujiza mpaka ukame ukaja.
So there are some crises that can come in your life. It's not coming to kill you. It's coming to promote what is within you.
Shida nyingine ikija kwako ikuje kukua inakuja kukuinua.
Yes sir. To someone here.
Yes sir.
So when you can see crisis,
ukiona shida,
dryness,
ukame,
whereby you never encounter such a dryness in your life.
Mahali ukupatana na ukame maisha.
That means God wants to move you to your comfortable place.
Mungu anataka kutoe kwa kustarehe.
And set you in a place where you can learn to fight.
Na kupeleke mahali ambapo utapigana miereka.
The Bible said, David said, I thank God who teaches my finger how to fight.
Barikiwe Mungu ambaye anefunza vidole vyangu vita.
That means God takes you in a place where you start learning how to fight.
Anakupeleka mahali vidole vyako vyajua vita.
As long as you are still in the place.
Kama uko katika starehe.
Of your parents.
Ndugu zako.
As long as you're still with your father.
Kama uko na baba yako.
You are getting too comfortable.
Umestareheka.
And these people will hinder your dream.
Na hawa watu watafungia ndoto yako. Kwa hivyo,
God has to cause the whole world.
Mungu afanye dunia yote.
A famine to come in the world.
Ukame ukaingia.
People were dying.
Watu wakafa.
I believe. But just to raise a man called Joseph.
Lakini kuinua jamaa anaitwa Yusufu.
God can cause circumstances.
Mungu anaweza leta shida.
Which can look as a disadvantage to others.
Inaweza ikakani kutofaidika.
But to you specifically.
Lakini kwako mwenyewe.
God has made sure for it not to be a disadvantage but an advantage.
Hakikisha wewe hautafaidika
mwenyewe. So you got to turn your eyes.
Lazima ubadilike.
The crisis of your neighbor is not your crisis. The disadvantage of your neighbor is not your disadvantage. Him not getting a job is not also your portion. Him not having now is not also your portion. Maybe God wants you to fight, but him, it's another case. But for you, he needs you to fight. So God has to send you to a place where you look left and right. No one is helping you. The people who were supposed to help you, they have shut their door. You are remaining in a place whereby you have no help. As right now where you are, you don't know who to call. You don't know who to take you out of the problem. That is the best place. God now wants your eyes to look at him. He's not looking for your focus. Son, look at me. I've blocked everything so that I can be your focus. Daughter of Maranatha, I've blocked everything so that you can look at me. Don't look at your problem. Look at me. Who's the altar and the finisher of your faith? If you can look at me, you shall make it. If you can focus, you shall reach. If you can believe, you will break forth. The yoke shall be broken. The yoke shall be broken. The yoke shall be broken. So in your toughest moments, look, lenga
kwa mtazamio,
because it came to remove you from your comfortable place.
Kwa hivyo ile shida ilikuja kutoka katika starehe.
God is tired of you with your 10,000.
Mungu amechoka na elfu yako 10.
He wants you to go to 100,000.
Anataka ufike elfu laki moja.
So he blocked the 10,000.
Hivyo anafunga elfu 10
until you can see the 100,000.
Paka uone laki moja.
I've just said something here, but I didn't.
Zakata, I pack it.
God is tired to see you renting.
Mungu amechoka ukodishe.
So he has blocked the way for you to pay rent.
Amefunga ukalipe
kodi. You start looking for rent everywhere, no rent.
Kodi hakuna.
God is looking for you to see your house.
Mungu anatazama uone nyumba yako. All right.
Any problem?
Shida
yoyote. This one, I learned it in 2014 or no, 2015. The Lord came to me and said, anything that you encounter,
chochote unakumbana nacho, Mungu akamwambia,
as crisis,
kama shida,
I've called you to dominate on it.
Nimekuita uitawale.
So if you encounter crisis of money,
ukikutana shida ya pesa,
that means you are anointed to dominate.
Umemwagiwa mafuta ubebe pesa.
If you ever encounter crisis like me, I was chased out of the house.
Mimi nikafukuzwa kutoka kwa nyumba
with my child and my family outside.
Na baba na familia wakatoka.
And the Lord said to me,
na Bwana akasema,
if such thing happened to you,
kama imekutendekea,
I anointed you,
nilikumwagia mafuta,
with properties,
ili ya kwamba upate manyumba na mali.
Listen, you cannot appreciate your properties
awezi ukafurahia mali yako
until the day you can remember that you were chased out.
Baka ile siku takumbuka ulifukuzwa.
Listen, you cannot appreciate your focus.
Awezi ukafurahia
gari yako. That's in the parking of your house.
Zimepangwa pango nyumbani.
Until the day you can remember.
Baka ile siku takumbuka.
One day,
siku moja,
someone left me.
Mtu aliniacha njiani.
Because he was in a hurry.
Maana alikuwa na gari kubwa akaenda zake. I hear you, sir.
I don't know. I know my story. I don't know about your story, but my story I know.
Yako sijui lakini yangu naielewa.
Coming down of a service.
Nitoka kwa ibada, baba katoka kwa ibada.
With my wife.
Akiwa na mama.
Rushing home.
Akikimbia nyumbani.
Because too much delegation, they want to see the prophet. Prophet.
Sababu wanataka waone nabii.
And then they can't remember that the prophet did not have a car.
Hawakumbuki nabii hana gari.
It's 10 p.m. 10 p.m.
Saa 4.
11 p.m.
Saa 5 jioni.
Prophet, I have problem.
Nabii niko na shida.
Men of God, we have problem.
Mtu wa Mungu tafadhali.
Pray for us.
Tuombe.
So the men of God sacrifice.
Tu wa Bwana akakaa.
Until 11 p.m.
Mpaka saa 5 jioni.
Not knowing that there was a woman.
Kulikuwa na mwanamke wakati huo.
Who used to take her home.
Ambaye alikuwa anapeleka baba nyumbani.
And she has a husband.
Na mke wa mume
wake. The moment of we are finishing.
Wakati wanamaliza.
With the last person.
Na ile wa mwisho.
11 p.m.
Ya 11.
We are coming down like this.
Saa 5 jioni.
No car.
Hakuna gari
alishawa. The parking was empty.
Ilikuwa parking na hakuna gari hata moja hata.
Calling the person. Uko wapi?
Akipiga simu, uko wapi?
No response.
Hakuna jibu.
No response.
Hakujibu.
No response.
Hajibu.
Until when she reached in the house.
Mpaka wakati alifikisha gari yake
kwa the phone call. She said, I'm home.
Niko nyumbani.
You guys found a way to get home.
Jipangeni.
But I thank God.
Nambariki Bwana.
Last month.
Mwezi uliopita.
Last month. I'm testifying.
Nakwambia na
last month.
Mwezi uliopita.
I am driving. And I thank God. My car was not tinted. Because it was new. I am driving. I see you are jealous of my testimony. You are jealous of my testimony. May God give you a testimony. Testimony. I've gotten into this place.
Baba anaendesha gari yake.
I saw a mother and a daughter.
Mwezi uliopita mama na mtoto wake.
Even if they are watching me,
hata
I don't care.
Kama wanatazama. Simu yao.
A mother and a daughter.
Mama na mtoto wake.
Walking.
Wakitembea.
They didn't have a car. Walking.
Hawakuwa na gari, wakitembea.
Looking forward to cross the road.
Wakivuka mbele ya gari yangu.
The time they are supposed to cross, that's the time my car reached.
Ile wakati wanavuka kwa barabara. Papa, say that again. Ndio wakati gari ya baba inafika.
Listen, this is my testimony.
Jesus
is coming as well.
Yako pia inafika.
After 4 years,
baada ya miaka minne,
they left me.
Waliniacha nikihubiri.
Here,
hapa,
I encountered them also walking.
Nikapata pia wakitembea.
But me,
lakini mimi,
I am driving.
Naendesha gari.
And the car was not tinted.
Na gari yake haikuwa tinted.
I put a brake.
Nikaeka brake kidogo.
I said, no, let me see well.
Nikasema acha nione
vizuri. Maybe I'm missing it.
Labda sio huyu.
Tell your neighbor, don't miss it. Don't miss it. Don't miss it.
Don't miss it. Don't miss it.
I put a brake.
Nikaeka brake.
And I say,
nikasema eh,
is so and so you.
Wewe ndiwe wewe uliniacha.
And the woman was just crossing like this.
Nakienda kuvuka.
And he saw me looking.
Nakaniona nikimtazama.
And putting the window down.
Na nikaeka kioo chini.
I call her name. She looked at me.
Akanitazama.
Together with the daughter.
Na wana binti yake.
Hey, prophet.
Hey, prophet. Hey. Ha-ha. Hey, prophet.
As well.
Watakwambia pia.
Hey Audrey.
Hey
Sarah.
Hey
Anne.
Hey
Purity.
Hey
Joel.
Hey
Sam.
Hey
Kefa.
Hey
Professor. May your enemies testify. May they celebrate you. May they celebrate you. May they celebrate you.
Take it. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Hey, prophet, I say, hey, yes, it is me.
Hey, ni mimi na sio ya kuomba.
It is me.
Isio kahaya.
It is me.
Hey.
I say, I didn't know that it was you. I just want to say hi, so I'm glad to see you again after a while. I hope you are doing well. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Sikujua.
We'll see you then.
Sikujua niona mtu barabara nikienda.
There is also something that tells you what is going back in the back.
Na kioo inaonyeshaga nini
kinatendeka. I looked at the mirror.
Nikatazama kioo.
I saw them panga restoring with the daughter.
Nikaona wakipanga. Yeah.
I say,
we, umeona?
That's my miracle.
Umeona? Eh? Na sio ya kuomba.
That's also your miracle.
Ayayayaya.
Listen to me, people of God.
Iskizeni watu wa Mungu.
And this is very true.
Na hii ni ukweli.
That Joseph today, all we all know.
Yusuf ambaye tunamjua sote.
No one was able to see.
Hakuna mtu aliyeona vile aliona.
What he was carrying.
Kile alichokibeba ndani yake.
Was God with him in a time of famine?
Mungu alikuwa katika ukame.
Yes.
Kabisa.
Was God with him in the pit?
Alikuwa naye katika shimo.
Yes.
Ndio.
Was God with him in the prison?
Alikuwa naye korokoro. Ndio. Yes, sir.
Why didn't God deliver him by then?
Kwa nini Mungu hakumkomboa siku zile?
He wanted him to go through the process.
Alimtaka Yusufu apitie mafunzo.
Go through the process.
Tia mafunzo na usipite darasa.
You might not understand.
Angeelewa.
Why just me?
Kwa nini me?
In all the people.
Kwa watu wote.
We finish school together.
Tulimaliza shule na
just me.
Mimi tu.
Remaining in the same place.
Nabaki kwa ishi.
All the people have helped.
Watu wote wame.
They have all access in high places.
Wameenda mbali.
But me are still in this place.
Mimi niko hapa.
Listen.
Skiza.
Listen.
Skiza.
Listen.
Skiza.
Your time.
Wakati wako.
Will be more brighter.
Utakuwa wakunga. Zaidi.
No one.
hakuna,
was able to discover.
Angeagundua.
Joseph.
Yusufu.
He had wisdom.
Alikuwa na hekima.
Are you listening to me?
Yes, sir.
He had wisdom.
Alikuwa na hekima.
He had the knowledge.
Alikuwa na
ufahamu. Already inside of him.
Ndani yake.
But God could see.
Lakini Mungu
you're not yet ready for it.
Ya kwamba hako tayari.
Let me expose you.
Wacha ni kufunue.
To serious battle.
Kwa vita.
Crisis.
Shida.
Lack of money.
Kukosa pesa.
Lack of breakthrough.
Kukosa upendo.
No businesses.
Hakuna biashara.
No connections.
Hakuna kuungana.
So that I can see. How big will you stretch your faith?
Vile utang'aa katika imani
yako. And God made sure again.
Na Mungu akahakikisha.
After all that.
Baada ya hiyo.
Putting you in the pit.
Weka ndani ya shimo.
For days in the darkness.
Kwa siku za giza.
Pulling you out.
Kutoa.
A child of promise.
Mtoto
promise
wa agano.
A child of promise.
Mtoto wa ahadi.
Going such through such problems.
Tia shida hizi.
After that.
Baada ya hiyo.
They removed you.
Wakamtoa.
They put you chain.
Wakamweka mdomo.
Hapo hapo.
Wakamfunga hapo.
Your father is there.
Baba yako yuko.
My, me, God,
nini?
What did I do?
Nini, nilifanya nini?
For my brother to do this
Dugu
to me. The same way you are crying.
Vile unalia.
I have, nimefanya nini?
Nimefanya nini?
For people to hate me like
watu
this. I have done what for
nimefanya
people to speak
nini?
Evil against
watu
me this way.
Mabaya,
I didn't do anything bad.
Hakuna kitu
but listen to me.
Lakini
the greatness in you is what has caused them
ndio imewafanya
to push you
wakusukume
to your destiny.
Katika hatima yako.
You can encounter a situation
whereby
you are seen like the bad person
when unaonekana mbaya
in the whole place
mahali yote
because you are chosen.
Kwa sababu umechaguliwa.
Katagusa.
Thank you, Father.
So through the tough time,
katika wakati
through the hard season,
katika magumu,
Joseph had a secret.
Yusufu alikuwa na siri.
And the treasure
na alikuwa na hazina,
which was one
ambayo ilikuwa moja.
He had God.
Alikuwa na Mungu.
No matter what comes,
haijalishi kile
kitakacho. I only have one friend.
Nina mmoja
who still accompany me until now.
Ambaye ana
mimi while my father is left there.
Wakati baba yangu
not to save me. But this one I have here.
Lakini huyu nina.
I'm going through together with him. They chain me together with him.
Walinifunga.
They put me in the pit together with him. And he's still with me.
Na bado yuko na mimi.
So I get amazed when people are going through the toughest time. They say God has left me. He has not left you.
Mungu hajakuacha.
Oh, why God is allowing this problem? No, he's allowing it so that you can see his presence.
Anairuhusu uone uwepo wake.
Next to your house.
Kiwa karibu na wewe. Tabusha.